We eat a whole lot of cabbage here in Eastern North Carolina, and usually it's on the side of a barbecue plate.
Hey.
What's up?
My friend Sam Jones runs one of the most well-known barbecue joints in the whole world. The Skylight Inn and his family, they're like barbecue royalty, and I love their slaw.
So I know y'all have a really complex menu here. I grew up eating here.
Yeah, so it's whole hog barbecue, coleslaw, cornbread. We have thrown a curve, and we do have chicken.
Well, not everybody eats pork.
Unfortunately not, and that's something we haven't been able to figure out why. I mean, everybody's got a right to be wrong, I guess.
So I'm going to Feast Portland this weekend, which is a food festival, and I'm participating in this event called Smoke. And I guess because I'm from Eastern North Carolina, they think that I cook over live fire all the time, but
I mean,
I don't. So I decided I would do cabbage.
That's kind of a cop-out. But...
So my idea is to take cabbage and kind of make the whole package taste like the experience of eating here. So I've got a cornbread product. I'm gonna have pig ears that are fried with cornmeal. And I'm gonna have the barbecued cabbage that's cooked in a stock made with your pork bones. And then a dressing that would be something like a slaw dressing, which I know is really complicated. It's just gonna take us about 3 hours to make this morning.
Not at all. And we call it slaw juice.
Slaw juice.
So this machine here is the slaw machine. It's actually an old Hobart grinder.
And your slaw is a lot finer than
most. It's almost minced.
Yeah.
I like a sweet slaw myself.
I do too.
I think on our style of pork, for instance, it should be a sweet slaw.
Yeah, because the pork is really tangy and fatty, and I think the sweetness balances it.
You fix a pork sandwich here. It's automatic. There's slaws coming on it. That may be in the Bible somewhere, but I'm not sure.
So how much cabbage do you go through every day?
It varies. We'll use anywhere from 1,500 to 2,000 pounds a week.
Holy.
Yeah.
So did you have a job in here when you were a kid?
When I was a child, my father, who's a Baptist minister, left to go to church. One of the guys walked up and said, "Hey, man, well, we're about out of coleslaw." I thought, that'd be awesome if I knew how to make it. And I called my dad on the phone. Everything he told me was about. Put about this of mustard, put about this of mayonnaise. And I thought, there's no way I'm going to get this slaw right. But I guess the good Lord smiling upon me, we made it and it tasted right.
Well, you've probably eaten it, you know, 5,000 times at that point. So you knew at least what it should look like.
And I ask everybody in here, hey, taste this before we put it out front, make sure it's right.
So can we cut some cabbage?
We can.
That's a big old head of cabbage.
You don't think I'm weird? I like cutting winter bread and knife.
Really? Why?
Just because.
It's too flexible.
Michael's gonna talk trash to me about using this knife.
I know,
you've got your hand here.
And the head of cabbage, and you're going into it to take the core out.
And the bread knife
works. Don't do it like this. Although I'm not doing that great. I'm not as strong as y'all.
It's easy preaching, hard living.
Cabbage is one of those things that's kind of like, I don't want to say poor people food, but it's always around. Spring, winter, summer, and slaw is as integral to Eastern North Carolina barbecue as the barbecue, in my opinion.
Yeah, you're very correct.
So that's enough there for a batch.
Every person that makes slaw has their own little thing that they do different. The recipe is the same, but the method will be different.
Okay.
So me, for instance, I always will put one stand of cabbage in here to start with.
You just called that a stand of cabbage. That would come from the term like lard stand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's a lot of sugar.
We've only begun.
Oh, my God. I am shocked right now.
Seriously?
I am.
That's going to be 8 gallons of coleslaw.
Okay, I thought that that was just for that amount of cabbage.
Oh, no, that's a pure diabetic emergency.
You got your yellow mustard, no Grey Poupon up in the Skylight Inn.
No.
This is health food right here.
It is cabbage.
It is cabbage. Wow.
It's a little ridiculous what these things cost, But they are so worth the
time it saves.
There it is.
That's it. I always look for that to start juicing up.
I don't like a slaw that's not juicy.
No, I like juicy slaw, absolutely.
And so, yeah, if I was gonna make me a sandwich right now, I would get my slaw like out of this pool of juice. That is awesomeness.
Yeah, because that leaches down into the vinegary barbecue. It's really, I can't wait to have lunch today at 10 a.m.